Although we have followed the verses from Mahatma Gandhi's biography for making this film, certain creative liberties have been taken to make the contents more understandable for the general audiences. In fact, it's an humble effort to document and present the history of this monument in relevance to Mahatma Gandhi's formative years of his life, which he spent here. We request the ardent Gandhians to view this film in that perspective.
As the Himalayas stand tall since time immemorial, the Ganga flows from its zenith into the nation that blossomed on its banks. Known as Bharat, India as it stands was conferred upon the name Hindustan in the medieval era.
It is this holy land where Gautam Buddha, Vardhaman Mahavir, Adi Shankaracharya, Swami Vivekananda, Aurobindo Ghosh, Narasimha Mehta, and Meera and allied alike shaped the culture of this nation.
But the man who accomplished unprecedented accord and assumed outstanding greatness for his impenetrable contribution towards casting the modern culture was none other than a son of this very soil, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. The great not only molded the culture but also addressed, advocated and practiced himself the doctrines of truth, love, compassion and non-violence.
This illustrious upbringing can be traced to this great monument, Kaba Gandhi no Delo.
Likewise, much though inclined to humanism, his fondness to the ultimate rhythm of achieving Swaraj, that is freedom, through non-violence was undoubtedly unparalleled. He led India and Indians towards challenging the might of imperialism, colonialism, and racism.
India is a composition of several linguistic states, and Gujarat forms a part thereof. Erstwhile, Kathiawar, Saurashtra, shared the territory of Gujarat. Porbandar and Rajkot are two vital cities that assumed resonant cradle to make history in relation to Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, father of the nation. Porbandar, the birthplace of Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, whereas Rajkot was where Gandhi spent the early years of his younghood. Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi was born at Porbandar on October 2, 1869.
Gandhi's father, Karamchand Gandhi, was fondly known as Kaba Gandhi. Whereas Delo, in colloquial Gujarati, connotes ambience of the entrance to the structure. This is how the premises owned by Karamchand Uttamchand Gandhi came to be known as Kaba Gandhi no Delo. While at Porbandar, in 1874, Karamchand Gandhi, that is Kaba Gandhi, was summoned and drafted to serve the territory as a state administrator. It was this event whereby Kaba Gandhi no Delo figured as a part of this history.
The family occupied this house in 1881 only. This residence, Kaba Gandhi no Delo, stands located at Lakhaji Raj Road, Kadiyanau line, which is 9th lane, Rajkot. The structure today has retained its original design as it was in 1881, except that a room over the main gate was demolished by the purchaser, reshaping the area as an open terrace after the sale by the Gandhis.
It is this very place that stands to testify the transformation from Mohan to Mahatma.
Gandhi has described his mother as a deeply religious woman and a homemaker. And it is essentially her deep faith in spirituality that had a great impact on Gandhi's own development and his saintliness.
Gandhi's formative education in Rajkot, while they resided at Kaba Gandhi No Delo, began at the primary school currently known as Kishore Singh Ji High School.
As a child, young Mohan was a very timid boy. It was here that a female maidservant, a caretaker named Rambha, imbibed devotion towards Lord Ram and emphasized reciting of Ram Nam to help him get away from any fears.
But much though distressing, teenager Mohan did succumb to certain unethical vices. While in this historical premises, he failed to inhale good and moral supportive friends. This caused adverse influence on young Mohan. Young Mohandas took to smoking along with one of his friends, for which he had also engaged in stealing the coppers from the servant's purse for the sake of buying Indian cigarettes. The boys realized their mistake and felt the agony of what they had done, as a result of which they attempted suicide by eating the datura seeds. Not having died of that, Mohandas considered this as an act of forgiveness and being forgiven.
Although the marriage of Gandhiji and Kasturba was solemnized at Porbandar, Kasturba's hometown, the marriage ceremony took place here only.
Gandhiji had his secondary education at the Kathiawad High School, renamed later as Alfred High School. This school had once again a change in the name, and it is currently known as Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi Vidyalay. Even today, this school stands as a monument in the memory of Mahatma Gandhi. It was here, during this first year in his high school, that an incident occurred. While during an examination visit of an educational inspector, his teacher tried to prompt him to copy and correct a spelling of one word kettle from his neighboring student's slate. Mohandas ignored the prompting, considering copying as an immoral act.
Without surrendering to his teacher's immoral guidance to copy the spelling of word kettle from his neighboring student, young Mohan still had many flaws to conquer.
But still, some healthy events such as reading the story of Shravan, his virtues and his upright devotion towards his parents, and also the glimpses of truth inhaled from Raja Harishchandra drama, miraculously subscribed in recasting young Mohan's approach to a diversified rejuvenation. Gandhi thus expected utmost loyalty from his wife and was extremely possessive about her. Having confessed it in his autobiography, he later termed this phase of his life as a jealous husband. Furthermore, Mohandas took to consuming meat. In his early youth, under the influence of a friend whose perspective on eating meat was linked with the idea of bodily strength. According to Gandhiji, as he writes, "It began to grow on me that meat eating was good. that it would make me strong and daring, and that if the whole country took to meat eating, the English could be overcome.
This is the part with a motive to repay debt of his brother. He got overpowered by theft too, when he stole gold from a golden ornament.
It was here that Gandhi was lured by his friend to visit a brothel. Where, according to Gandhi, he was saved by God as he was sent back by the lady with abuses as he could do nothing.
Mohan dwelt into a realm of introspection upon his behavior, having realized that he was missing the ethical quotient. He retaliated within himself to erase and set at rest the unethical and immoral past, and to gain and capture what was stored as a gift of upbringing.
His repentance had no bounds. To acknowledge his repentance and to exhibit his sincerity to desist from future similar indulgences, he addressed a note to his father, Karamchand Gandhi, apologizing and expressing his paramount will to rejuvenate and revert to a path imbibed where character valued. Being conscious of the guilt, young Gandhi could not cultivate courage to face his father and tender an apology in person. Therefore, he elected to tender his apology through this note. Upon reading the letter, that is note, Karamchand Gandhi shed tears, leave alone scolding.
This incident at Kabagandhino Delo was indeed a point of transformation. In effect, Gandhiji himself felt emotionally overwhelmed. The tears did assume a revolutionary rewinding of what was otherwise stored in future. Paved the way for his own understanding and adherence to Satya, which manifested in his action of confession, and Ahimsa, as his father did not hurt him.
This understanding became a part of the larger revolutionary values that Gandhi propagated and adhered, resulting in the realization of Swaraj.
It was at Kabagandhino Delo where Karamchand Gandhi passed away.
That night, Mohandas was with his father massaging his feet. But his uncle relieved him and Mohandas obliged. Because he wanted to be with his wife. But just within moments, the servant knocked his door. His father had left for the heavenly abode. Mohan considered the events surrounding this incident as shameful for him personally, and the guilt remained lifelong.
His two sons, Manilal and Harilal, were born here. Having cleared his matriculation in 1887 from Kathiawar High School, currently Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi Vidyalaya, Rajkot, obviously while at Kabagandhino Delo, Gandhiji travelled to Bhavnagar for further studies at Shamaldas College, Bhavnagar.
Mohandas Gandhi was thence a minor. While he was heading towards gaining majorhood, his exercise and will to unfold what was stored in future induced him to profess law and become a barrister. With that sense of purpose and dedication towards attaining it, in 1898, Gandhiji decided to move to England, albeit transcending the orthodoxy of the caste system that had for long stigmatized the action of travelling to foreign shores.
But firstly, Mohandas had to convince his mother, Putri Bai, since her consent was an essential prerequisite. It was in these premises that young Mohan affirmed and assured his mother in no ambiguous terms that he will desist from alcoholic substance and non-vegetarian foods. He further rendered a similar vouch to refrain from immoral sex.
Thank you. that was an era when caste, community and society at large would never ever uphold or share any move to travel abroad, overseas, and if one ventures, the individual would stand expelled from the community and society too. But Gandhiji was more than religious over his intent. In contrast, he was adequately aware about possible resentment he may have to confront. Nevertheless, he did hold tenacity to absorb such reprisals.
The sequence of events governing Gandhiji's touring to England, his unequivocal repentance thereupon making re-entry into Kabagandhino Delo, his visit to Africa and returning therefrom were all executed from instant premises. But one major event which changed the history of Indian freedom struggle was cradled here at Kabagandhino Delo after Mohandas came back to India from South Africa for the first time, and that was drafting of the Green Pamphlet, through which he exposed the conditions of Indian indentured laborers and coolies in South Africa. In this pamphlet, to make the Indians aware of conditions of Indians in South Africa. Since the jacket of these pages of appeal was green in color, it was known as the Green Pamphlet. Copies published 10,000 in number. He traveled to Bombay, Pune, Madras and Calcutta with these copies and met the national leaders then, made speeches regarding human rights. The Green Pamphlet was taken by the British as an anti-government publication. When Gandhi again reached Durban, his ship was not allowed to dock for 3 days. When he finally got himself dislodged, he was beaten by the whites. But despite this humiliation, he continued to work for Indian Natal Congress. So there's nothing wrong if we infer that the Mahatma who was in the making cradled at Kabagandhino Delo.
On his return from England first, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, for some cause, was obliged to meet agent to Governor General, then a representative from British regime. Apart from being not well received, Mahatma Gandhi was insulted and showed the way out through manhandling by a peon. This episode was perhaps an impetus to guide non-violent future struggle leading to Quit India movement.
Mahatma Gandhi was associated with Kabagandhino Delo till 1915. He did not visit his ancestral house, a Sanskar Bhumi, thereafter. Gandhi family's ownership rights over these premises were relinquished and the house was sold perhaps in 1920. The occupation of Kabagandhino Delo by the family lasted around 40 years, 1881 to 1920.
With well-deserved and untiring support from the nation at large, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, by then unanimously acclaimed as Mahatma Gandhi, successfully pioneered an unassuming and unarmed leadership to grab his long-cherished desire to free the nation from the clutches of majestic imperialism, an invaluable gift, causing total vacation of British rule. Though not wholly relevant, but it may be eventful to recapitulate breeding at Kabagandhino Delo.
With the advent of termination of British regime and on setting at rest related movements, the initial step taken by the democratic government was to disintegrate and dissolve princely states and rearrange the administrative setup. As an outcome, certain pockets, as in states, were formed with due regard to languages and area viable to administer. This planning and execution gave birth to Saurashtra state, among few others alike.
As a mark of lucid and good governance, the first chief minister of Saurashtra state, Sri Uchcharangarai Naval Shankar Debar, commonly addressed as Debar Bhai, with his foresight towards the first step, acquired this building, Kabagandhino Delo, on behalf of government and designated it as Monumental Memorial of Mahatma Gandhi. This memorial continues to be so maintained even at present.
In the early part of the decade commencing 1950, Gandhiji's sister Rariyatben stayed in this house. She had her last breath here only. Subsequent to conversion of this unit into a memorial, but before some useful activities can be developed, the premises were housed to nourish and augment spheres governing welfare of women and children.
It was Mahatma Gandhi's centenary year when this memorial assumed a legal status. Under the name and style Gandhi Smriti Trust, the founding members to administer this trust were the legendary characters Sarvashri U.N. Debar, that is Debar Bhai, Jethalal Joshi, Chimanlal Nagardas Shah and allied others.
The building, Kaba Gandhi no Delo, was drastically damaged, almost dilapidated during 2001 earthquake. With the goodwill assistance from district administration, government of Gujarat, the premises were thoroughly repaired and renovated. Of course, otherwise existing structure continues unimpaired. The photographic exhibition exhibiting Mahatma Gandhi's numerous photographs had also worn out and tattered. Here again, with the financial patronage from Rajkot Municipal Corporation, the photo exhibition is now totally retrieved with altogether a novel look.
Currently, apart from Mahatma Gandhi's own photographs, this exhibition does depict similar allied photographs that act as a narrative album to describe life sketch, incidences and happenings of Mahatma Gandhi, father of the nation. Further, the publications in the form of books written up by Mahatma Gandhi, as also writing published by Navjeevan Trust, as available, do find a place in this gallery. The incepts of this structure, Kaba Gandhi no Delo, dates back to 1881 age-wise. It is now 135 years old. The location too is very dense and thickly populated area. The movement of cross-vehicular traffic is increasingly difficult. The usable area within the premises is also far too limited to ventilate better planning.
Keeping these factors in view and to safeguard the convenience of visitors, no further welfare activity or program is viable and hence restricted. The intention again is to ensure visitors' comfort during visit of this national monument, as also to ease extending uninterrupted prayers and homage to the father of the nation. Nevertheless, on 2nd October, Gandhi Jayanti and 30th January, death anniversary, prayer meetings are held every year at Kaba Gandhi no Delo.
While rewinding and ruminating the chronologies of history leading to Mahatma Gandhi's struggle for independence, as also governing transformation of Mohan into Mahatma, events, incidents and reminiscences of Kaba Gandhi no Delo, a sanskar bhumi, would stand displayed on unaltered pages in the history.
Thus, this monument stands as a citadel of tolerance, compassion, kindness, truth and ahimsa, and a measure of bringing these values into practice in everyday life. The corridors of this place have stood witness to the practice of these values in every sphere of our existence. May all who visit take back an iota of inspiration to be, as Gandhi said, the change that you wish to see in the world, as the spirit of transformation from Mohan to Mahatma eternally lives on.